I wanted to keep you guys up to date. Right now, I am getting ready to meet with a fertility specialist. One. I love you. Hey, are you gonna be a good boy for grandma?
Yeah.
Okay. Be on your best behavior, no screaming.
Yeah. Should we go walk her out?
Yeah.
Okay, put your, here, wipe your hands.
Bye, Lincoln.
Bye.
I'll see you in a couple days. I'll be here.
Okay.
I'll come stay at Graham's house, okay?
Okay.
Bye. Stay warm, it's cold. Good morning, guys, and happy Tuesday. Welcome to today's vlog. I'm currently sitting outside of the doctor's. I have an appointment in 15 minutes, so I wanted to catch you guys up to date. Let me turn those off so I don't keep windshield wipering. It is freezing today. Last night, it got down to 37 freaking degrees. It was so cold. So when we woke up, we had to bundle up. The heater went on 2 days ago. It's like been so cold here. I wanted to keep you guys up to date. Right now, I am getting ready to meet with a fertility specialist. One, not so much like, obviously we want to get pregnant. So that's like case in point. However, I want to talk to her about the PCOS, if she believes that birth control will be a good thing to help regulate it, or if she thinks something else is better for our situation. So I met with her over the phone yesterday, which was different to have like a phone conversation. It was kind of nice because I didn't have to drive. But now I'm meeting with her in person and she's going to do some blood work. We're going to do an ultrasound. She wants to look at my ovaries and she wants to see how many eggs I have in them. She wants to look at my ovaries to see if she in fact confirms that it's PCOS. The last 2 days I have had positive ovulation tests. Now it's not unheard of for me to have positive ovulation tests. I haven't got pregnant this last really year and a half of us trying. So we don't believe that I have in fact ovulated just since my period's been so irregular, but I'm getting positive ovulation tests. She wants to see if I in fact did ovulate, which the last 2 days I got positive ovulation test. Last night I got a negative ovulation test. This morning I also got a negative ovulation test. So she is going to check to see if I in fact ovulated. That would be a great sign if I did, because that means my body is still ovulating, which is a good thing. So fingers crossed, keep me in your prayers. I should know. Keep watching this video and you'll know if I've ovulated. I'm going to try to record what I can. I'm not gonna like pull the camera out like, hey, can we talk? But maybe she'll let me sneak a few little sessions on my phone since Louis is not in there. Louis's at the house with some people getting our house ready. We had to have a couple things, like some locks changed, just a couple things done with the house. So Louis's with them at the house, and then Fran is with Lincoln and Leroy at her house. She's gonna watch him for a couple days for me just so I can get things really up and ready, and then we will be leaving this weekend to go stay with Fran and Leroy while we have showings at our house, so I don't have to like keep cleaning because I ain't no one got time for that. Good morning, guys, and happy Wednesday. Welcome to today's vlog. Now, this is going to be a two-parter. So day two, yesterday you saw that I was getting ready to go into my doctor's appointment, and right after that it got so busy I had to rush home to get the kids from school because it's freezing out. It's in the 30s and I didn't want them walking home, so I had to rush home and get them. And then it was literally work, 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 take care of the kids, work, 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 that I didn't have a free moment to sit down and talk to y'all, and I feel like I want to say a lot, and so I didn't want to just like rush it. I wanted to be able to talk to y'all. I'm actually gonna be going and getting my hair done in a few minutes, but I have a couple seconds. Well, I have like 15 minutes, and I figured I should be able to say what I wanna say in 15 minutes before I have to get my hair done. So, let me update you on the appointment yesterday. Overall, an amazing appointment. Better than I could have ever hoped for. So I went into the doctor's office and I got all checked in. She took my blood pressure. She said it was perfect. And then I went in to get my ultrasound. She didn't want to take my blood yet because she kind of wanted to see what the ultrasound was showing. First, she felt around my belly. She said it felt good. She came from behind and she checked my thyroid with her hands and she said it felt normal. And then like she's checking for any lumps or anything like that. And then she felt my belly and she's like, okay, that feels good. And then she took the ultrasound thingamajig that she's going to do a transvaginal ultrasound, going to check my uterus, check my ovaries, and kind of see what's going on. A little backstory, I hadn't had my period for 4 months. Now, the last year and a half, my periods have been very irregular. I was getting to the point where 4 months was my longest I've ever gone. However, I've gone 3 months, 2 months. I would say I probably have about 6 periods a year, probably, if not less. So she was checking to see what was going on. I told the fertility specialist, which by the way, she was amazing, love her. She had told me that she was gonna check me for PCOS so she could verify if I do in fact have it. And so when she went into my uterus, she said I have fluid above my uterus, which means that I could have ovulated. So that was one sign that I could have ovulated, which let me back up again. So I didn't have a period for 4 months. Finally, last month in September, September 16th and 17th, I bled for 2 days. And I was like, well, was that a period? Like, what was that? And I haven't had my period since, which I would be like 11 days late, but I'm not pregnant, took a pregnancy test. So that's like not, it's not weird for that to happen. So I was like, wow. Am I in fact ovulating? Because if I do in fact have PCOS, women have a hard time ovulating. Sometimes you have so much testosterone that you don't ovulate because your follicles can't get big enough. This is what I've learned in the last week. I am not a fertility specialist. I am not an OB. Don't take what's going on with me as like what's gonna happen with you. This is just what I've learned in the last weeks. I'm not gonna like cure you or the world, but hopefully this will just give you kind of answers that maybe if you're struggling with this, maybe you can go to an OB and then get a second opinion from a fertility specialist. She did say that my uterus lining is really thick, which with PCOS, because I'm not ovulating and having a period every month, I am just getting like a thicker line, which if you have PCOS, you want to get it under control because you want to in fact have a period. If that lining keeps building up, you can potentially get uterine cancer, which that's why I was so eager to, okay, if my OB said I have PCOS, I want to investigate this because I don't want it to cause problems in the long run, because my grandmother did die from heart disease, and heart disease with PCOS is a high probability, and then also uterine cancer. So I wanted to get this under control. She went to check my right ovary first. Now she did tell me, you want to think of your ovaries like bank accounts. And the more follicles, cysts they call them, but they're really follicles, you have in your ovaries is the more money you have, okay? So basically the more fertile you are. She went into my right ovary and she's like, okay, let me count. So she starts counting, she gets quiet and she counts 31. She's like, let's just say you're really wealthy on that side. She's like, but I don't see any like large mature follicles like you ovulated on that side. I'm like, okay. So then she got quiet and she's like, I'm gonna go to your left now. And she starts counting and she's like, you have 28. She's like, you are very fertile, my friend. She's like, you have a lot. You could have a lot of babies if you want. So that was like the best news ever. I was like, oh my gosh, now let's find out if I've ovulated because I got the two positive. And then yesterday I didn't get a positive. So I was like, okay, 2 days, that's cool. When she was in that side, she saw a, let me see if I can say this right, corpus luteum, which basically that is a follicle that has matured, that if you have sex because you've ovulated that same day, that your chances of getting pregnant are really, really high. So she told me, you have one that's like right there. Go home, have date night with your husband, and you could potentially get pregnant. So I was like, what? That is the best news ever. Like, this could be happening so fast for us. So I was like, I mean, even though it hasn't happened so fast, we've been trying for a year and a half now. Like, we haven't prevented since Lincoln because we never really prevent, but we've been like trying for a year and a half and nothing's happened, and I've had irregular periods and I haven't been able to track any of my ovulations. Some months I don't even ovulate, because I did ask the doctor, if I don't in fact have a period the next month, did I ovulate? And she's like, no, you have to have a period to ovulate. And so I was like, okay. So she was like, go home, have a fun time with your husband, and let me see you back Monday to check your progesterone levels to see if everything's going good. That is where we're at right now. I went home, my husband and I did the deed, and fingers crossed that maybe in a couple weeks, maybe 2 weeks, she said the 8th. So y'all be watching out, because the 8th I should either get my period or I should have a positive pregnancy test. Guys, I'm so excited. Like, it's the best news ever. Going from how I felt last month, like down in the dumps, like that I wasn't gonna ever be able to have babies anymore, that I was going through menopause, like I felt so heartbroken. When you're told that you could potentially not have any more children, when you want children, when your heart longs for another child, it hurts. And my heart literally hurts for every woman that has a hard time getting pregnant, because it sucks. It sucks to, I mean, and I had it, I feel like I had it minor to what y'all have had it if you've gone through infertility where you have to do IVF and it doesn't work, and you know, you long for a child. Like, my heart hurts for you. And if that's you, message me and I want to talk to you. I want to send all our prayers your way. We are thinking about you, we are praying for you, and we hope that your month is to come, because every woman that desires to have a baby should have a baby. And yeah, my heart breaks for you. So we're praying for you, we're thinking about you. And that's the update. That is where we are now. Now I'm gonna go in and get my hair done because I think it's time. Yep, 2 minutes, so I need to go. But that is the update.
Yeah, Tatum's gonna bring it tomorrow to grandma's.
Tatum
ordered it online from Amazon.
Tatum did it. This is what a good big brother you got, huh, Lincoln?
We're gonna bring it to Graham's tomorrow, okay?
Daniel, give me down.